Hello, my lovely students. Good morning. Hope so you are fine and taking due care of yourself. Dear students, welcome to digital classes. Samay 10 se 12 wala har ghar bane paathshala. This is your chemistry class and I am your chemistry teacher. So today, especially we will discuss about the numerical related to cell potential and Nernst equation. As in yesterday's video, we discussed about the cell potential and couple of example also we have discuss, but today especially one question is coming in your exam that is related to cell potential or Nernst equation. So especially I'm making this video related to tell you about the numericals. Okay, so keep watching these videos and try to solve the numericals with me. So dear students, as in previous video we have studied about electrode potential. It is the potential difference that develops between the electrode and electrolytes, and related to this we have studied one example, that is formulate the electrochemical cell in this particular this example, and how to calculate the E naught cell value, that is coming 0.30, that already we have done. Related to same topic, one more question I am going to take today so that we can understand this numerical proper. So this is an example that is given in your modern ABC book, that is calculate the standard reduction of electrode potential of nickel to positive to nickel electrode when the cell potential for the cell nickel converting to nickel to positive in 1 mole and copper to positive is converting into copper in 1 mole. It means that 1 mole is unity, and the potential difference we have, that is 0.59 volt. It means that E naught cell is already given there. The value of E naught cell is given. So as we are doing, I'm going to take the same question with in my way. Okay. So let's take some of the examples. Suppose this is the numerical related to calculated cell potential. Cell potential mean E naught cell we are calculating, okay, one side of the half cell. Okay, so this is the type 1 and type 2 type of question. There are this type of numerical is coming in two language. Number one, in which it is they can ask calculate E naught cell, in which that we need to calculate the complete cell potential. So problem is there, one question I have taken from your modern ABC book, that is write the half cell reaction and overall reaction for the electrochemical cell. Dear students, try to understand carefully and you need to practice all the questions that is given in NCERT book. So zinc converting to zinc to positive, it is taking 1.0 mole, whereas lead to positive become lead in 1.0 mole. Okay, so calculate the standard EMF for the cell. We need to calculate the standard EMF for the cell. It means that we need to calculate the standard electrode, single electrode, as we have taken 1 mole, that's why the value is standard. Second, standard electrode potential of lead to lead positive is minus 0.126 volume volt, it is according to that table. So whereas zinc to positive zinc is minus 0.763. so this is that kind of question where the value of volt has already given, value of concentration has given, we just need to calculate the standard electrode, standard value of standard EMF of a cell. Okay, so here zinc we are taking as anode, lead we will take as a cathode. If zinc is anode, it means that it will carry oxidation, and lead is cathode, it is carrying showing reduction. Okay, so first step is identification of electrode. Now second step, we will write the cell reaction. As question is asked, they write the half cell reaction. Okay, so in oxidation cell reaction you will write loss of electron. So zinc is showing us zinc 2 positive plus 2 electron, these 2 electron is losing, whereas on the other hand side reduction, lead is gaining those 2 electron forming lead. So overall reaction become zinc plus lead, which is in reactant side, zinc plus lead 2 positive, and on the product side zinc 2 positive plus lead. Okay, now you know very well how to calculate E naught cell. Cell potential can be calculated by E cathode minus E anode, or E right side minus E left side. Okay, so this is the general formula. E naught cell is equal to E naught left hand side, right hand side we have lead and left hand side we have zinc. So minus 0 point, this value already has given in question. So in place of this cathode or lead, 2 positive or lead, we will write minus 0.126, minus and the value of this is 0. Okay, 0.763. so 0 minus minus plus plus minus minus, so it is giving E cell, E naught cell, 0.67637 volt. So dear student, this is the cell potential of this particular cell. So very simple, we should have these two value. If these two value has given, so we can calculate. And if you don't know these values, if it is not given in question, then you can learn it from that table. Okay, let's talk about the second type of type 2 numerical from this cell potential. So it is coming calculate the standard reduction potential of any half cell. Now here cell potential has already given. Here too we are completing complete cell potential we are finding. Here if cell potential is already given, then how we can find out the standard reduction potential of any one electrode. Okay, So calculate the standard reduction of electrode potential of nickel. Suppose specific, they are asked there. Nickel to positive to nickel electrode. When the cell potential of complete cell is given, nickel to positive 1 mole, copper to positive to copper is 1 mole. And total cell potential is 0.59 volt. Okay. So as we know that copper to positive to copper, it is 0.34 volt. So we can write the cell. Nickel to positive 1 mole, copper to positive to copper 1 mole, okay. And if it is 1 mole, it is called standard. The EMF cell is E cell E right minus E left. As you know, E naught cell is already given 0.59 volt. E copper rod has also given 0.34 volt. But we don't know about E nickel to positive electrode potential. So with this, we will calculate. It is also very simple. Put all the formulas here in this formula. E naught cell is equal to E copper to minus E nickel to positive. Here copper is on right hand side and nickel is on left hand side. So 0.59 volt is total cell potential, whereas copper cell potential is this. But we need to calculate this. So we will take this side, this side, and after calculating, it will come minus 0.25 volt. Nothing is difficult here. Just you need to focus how to calculate. Okay. So these are the two type of question. Now we will discuss next. The numerical related to non-stick wire. So dear students, sometime the questions are asked in the board exam related to numerical related to non-stick question. So that's why I'm taking this seriously, and you need to practice this also. One thing I want to tell you related to numerical. Maximum students, they are afraid from numerical and they are avoiding the numerical by thinking that numericals are very difficult. But let me tell you, once you will start the numerical with the proper process, then you will enjoy the numerical, and mathematically numerical is giving us full marks. So just focus on numerical, don't avoid the numerical, don't ignore the numerical, practice again and again, definitely you will get high score. Okay, so if we are talking about Nernst equation, so your focus should be the equation of Nernst equation. As in yesterday's video, we very clearly we derive that why this formula is like this way. So it is E cell. Now we are not finding out cell potential, we are finding the EMF of cell, electromotive force of cell. So electromotive force of cell can be calculated by taking E cell constant, E cell potential, E naught cell, minus 2.303 RT upon NF log M upon M positive. You know very well from where this value came. We are taking rate constant, temperature, number of electron in Faraday coulomb, but 2.303 is coming when we natural log we are converting into logarithm. Okay, so at 298 Kelvin, always be after calculating, E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 0.059 N log 1 upon M naught N plus. Those students who are getting confused ki from where this value came now, so they have to watch previous video, that is yesterday's video. In that video, I clearly told you how to calculate, how we have calculated these values by putting universal values R 0.831, F 965, approximately 9658, N is number of electron. So after calculating these values, we got this approximate value. Now we are taking this value simple to calculate the numericals. Okay, so let's take an example. If E naught for copper electrode is 0.34 volt, if E naught, you know very well for copper E naught value is 0.34 volt, and you need to calculate EMF value. It means that this formula will use whenever it is written, calculate EMF value. When the solution is in contact with its 0.1 mole of copper ion. Okay. And how does the EMF of copper electrode change when concentration of copper to positive ion in the solution is decreased? So let me tell you, we need to calculate the numerical basic in three steps. So divide whole values in three steps. As you know that in exam, nothing is there except this question language. So from the language, we need to find out given first. Suppose this is given. This is given what? It is given E cell constant of copper. That is this. So it is concentration E cell copper of this is 0.34 volt. As it is written as 0.1 mole. That is the concentration of copper to positive. This is 0.1 mole. We need to convert in scientific notation to become 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 1. And number of electron is copper 2 positive is there. So if copper 2 positive is there, so it means that number of electron is 2. These are the basic hint that is given to us. Now from these hint, we need to formulate the equation. Equation is simple equation. You have only one equation. That equation we will write, and with this equation, the values we will, these values we will put in equation. We need to calculate. So see, E cell, E naught cell minus 0.059 upon 2 log 1 upon copper 2 positive, 1 upon copper 2 positive. Whereas the copper 2 positive formula we know, the concentration we know 0.1. So when we write 0.1, it will convert into 1 into 10 raised to power minus 1 in scientific notation. Whereas N is 2, we will write N2 here. Whereas copper is E naught cell is 0.34. Everything is given, just you need to put it in right equation.
After that, you should have mathematical aptitude. 0.34 volt into 0.0592 upon 2. 0.059 upon 2 will divide. It gives 0.0295. Whereas log 1 upon 1 into 10 minus 1. So 10 minus 1 is, it become 1 upon 10 minus 1. Whereas 10 minus 1, when we'll take up, it become log 10 plus 1. Okay. So log 10 is always equal to 1. This is universal, you can keep it in your mind. Log 10 is always 1, log 1 is always 0. Okay, so log 10 is equal to 1, whereas if this value will multiply with 1, it will remain same. So this minus this, this is the answer. Okay, this is one. Second type of question can ask in this question, calculate the standard electrode potential of nickel to positive to nickel electrode, the cell potential of this is. So what is the difference between this type of question and this type of question? In this type of question, there is no cell reaction is given, only from language we need to understand. And in this kind of reaction, there is reaction is given. So you need to understand what is the cell reaction. As yesterday's video, again, I have told you cell representation. Nickel converting to nickel to positive ion at 0.01 mole. Now this mole is also, earlier we were discussing about 1 mole. Now from 1 mole, from standard, we have now different value of concentration, 0.01 mole. Whereas copper to positive will convert in copper in the 0.1 mole. Okay. Whereas overall cell potential is 0.59 volt and overall cell potential of copper is 0.34. So same step one is, we need to write the reaction. We need to identify in this reaction, basically this reaction I have converted in this form. To identify the oxidation and reduction. For oxidation and reduction, we should know where is electron is losing from where the electron is gaining. So here nickel 0, here 2 positive. It means that 2 loss of electron is there. Whereas 2 positive to 0, it means that 2 gain of electron is there. The loss of electron is called oxidation. So nickel is oxidizing. And gain of electron is called reduction. So copper is reduction. So this side nickel is writing. So that oxidation we will write on the left hand side. Reduction we will write on the right hand side. We need to calculate here E naught cell. So E is equal to E naught cell minus 0.059 upon N, nickel 2 positive upon copper 2 positive. Now here you need to focus oxidation upon reduction, it is oxidation upon reduction. So nickel is oxidation, that's why we identify oxidation reduction, so that we will write here. Otherwise most of the time students is writing copper upon nickel, that is wrong. So nickel upon copper, and value of nickel is given here. Value of nickel is 0.01 and value of copper is 0.1. So the value we will put here. After putting the value, we need to calculate 0.59 volt is given total cell. Now cell potential of copper, we need to, cell potential of nickel, we need to calculate. So how to calculate cell potential of this complete cell? Again the same formula, Nernst equation, log 0.01 upon 0.1, 0.59 volt, E naught cell minus 0.295 log. It means that 0.01. convert into scientific notation. After decimal there is 2 digit 1 2, so it become 10 raised to power minus 2. After decimal there is 1 digit, it become 10 minus 1. So if you will cut it, it become 10 minus 1 on the top. So it is written, it can be written in the form of 1 upon 10. So if 1 upon 10 is there, so log 10 is 1 and log 1 is 0, so 0 minus 1 is minus 1. So minus 1 will multiply with minus 0.0295, it become minus plus 0.0295. okay, and if we need to calculate this, this we will take this side, this we will take this side, and the formula is now this minus this, and it becomes 0.5605. don't forget to write bolt. Okay, so these are the basic two formulas on related to that numerical is can be asked, and two formulae I have told in the two different types. Okay, so today I'm going to share you PDF. In this PDF I'm going to share the numerical related to these two formulas and the numerical which has asked in the previous few years. Although some of the numericals can be solved, so you have to practice again and again just to make yourself perfect in this numerical. If you are having any problem, you are facing any problem, you are free to call me. You are free to call me anytime, anywhere. Okay. So dear students, hope so you enjoyed this video, you understood this video. Keep watching 2-3 times the video to better, for a better understanding. So till my next video, thanks a lot for watching this video. Stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself, take care of your family also. Okay, thank you.